Good morning students. This video is continuation of plant kingdom. So in your previous video lessons you were studied that plant kingdom that includes algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Okay, so today's class that is about gymnosperms. So we'll study gymnosperms in detail. So gymnosperms that are the first plants to have seeds. Okay, gymnosperms that are the first plants to have seeds. The gymnosperms, here you can see various examples for gymnosperms. So see the image, and here this one cycas, pinus, neatum. Next, here zamia, thuja, podocarpus, zincago, biloba, auricaria, pinus. So these are all different gymnosperms. Gymnosperm, that is from the Greek, gymnos, that means what, naked, and sperma, that means what, seeds. The gymnosperms are plants in which the ovules are not enclosed by any ovary wall and remain exposed both before and after fertilization. So once again, I'll repeat this one. The gymnosperms are plants in which the ovules are not enclosed by any ovary wall and remain exposed both before and after fertilization. The seeds that develop post fertilization, and these seeds are not covered. So hence they are called naked seeded plant. So in a simple word, here only seeds are present, but there is what? No fruit. Okay, only seeds are produced here, but there is what? No fruit. So these plants, they are referred as naked seeded plants. Understood this one? So gymnosperms means here no fruit, only seeds are produced. So these plants that are referred as naked seeded plants. So these are the group of vascular plants. Okay, these are the group of vascular plants, means here presence of vascular tissues, that is xylem and phloem, to conduct water and food. So plants that reproduce by means of an exposed seeds or ovules. These are groups of vascular plants that reproduce by means of an exposed seeds or ovules. So they are phanerogams. Phanerogams means seed bearing plants. So in this image you can see cone that containing water seed. These seeds are used for reproduction purpose, and this is one of the gymnosperm plants. Here you can see the leaves that are needle like leaves. Most gymnosperms are evergreen with the small percentage that tends to be deciduous. See here, majority of the gymnosperms plants, they are always green. Only some that are deciduous. Okay, most are trees, means they are woody stem, for example redwood. Then few are, only few are, we can see it as a shrubs. Then seeds are not borne on flower or in fruit like angiosperms. Angiosperms means these are flowering plants. So here seeds are borne on flower or in fruit, but here in gymnosperm seeds are not borne on flower or in fruit. One of the gymnosperms, the giant redwood tree. So in this image you can see here coast redwood, giant sequoia. So different gymnosperms plants, see their height also given. One of the gymnosperm, the giant redwood tree sequoia, is one of the tallest tree species. So here you can see that what their height, see the height of that plant, coast redwood, nearly 367 feet, and this one giant sequoia, that is 300 feet. Okay, so sequoia is one of the tallest tree species. And here also you can see the structure of cones and leaves that are needle shaped leaves. So gymnosperms, again, once again I'll repeat this one, that are seed bearing plants. Then seeds are not enclosed by ripened ovary, means fruit is absent. Then they bear separate male and female cones, Understood? They bear separate male and female cones, have vascular tissues, then have roots that extend over wide surface area. They nearly 700 to 900 species. So gymnosperms means they are seed bearing plants. Seeds are not enclosed by ripened ovary. That means here fruit is absent. Understood? Only seeds are produced, fruit is absent. They bear separate male and female cones. For example, in some gymnosperm, for example, Pinus, that is one of the gymnosperm plant, here in only one plant, we can see the both male and female cones. But in Cycas, male cones that are produced in male plant and female cone that are produced in female cones, female plants. Okay, so male cone in male plant and female cone in female plant, whereas in Pinus, both male cone and female cone that are produced in a single plant. Then they have vascular tissues and have roots that extend over wide surface area. And gymnosperms means here nearly 700 to 900 species. We'll get 700 to 900 species. Then gymnosperms that are produce cones, that are reproductive part, okay, male cone and female cone. Then gymnosperms, they are propagate via wind pollination. So wind, that is responsible for transfer of pollen grains to the ovule. Okay, wind is responsible for the transfer of pollen grains to the ovule. The adult plant body, that is called what? Sporophyte. The plant body is called here sporophyte. It represented by perennial evergreen woody plant. So all the plants, they are sporophyte plant. Okay, most of them are trees and some are shrubs. Already we discussed once this one. Then there are no herbs. Herbs means that is very small plants. So gymnosperms plants means most of the trees, they are woody trees. Okay, and only some are shrubs. But in gymnosperms we cannot see any herbs. Pinus as well as other coniferous, they are evergreen trees. Then here, axis grow taller, it increases in diameter due to secondary growth. So stem branches, here we can see two types of branches. One is long shoots or branches of unlimited growth. Another one, dwarf shoots or branches of limited growth. Long shoots or branches of unlimited growth and dwarf shoots or branches of limited growth. Let us see about their root. Okay, what is the structure of root? So gymnosperm plant, they possess what? Tap root. Elongated structure with strong lateral branches here. Root hair scanty. Okay, the function taken up by ectotrophic mycorrhiza. So fungus root. So here plant associated with a plant that is associated with the fungus here, that is called mycorrhiza. It is a symbiotic association of fungal mycelium on the root surface that helps in the absorption of nutrients and protection from the pathogens. Okay, so that helps in a, so mycorrhiza, because of this one symbiotic association, that helps in the absorption of nutrients and protection from pathogens. See here, roots, the roots generally, that once again I'll explain this one. The roots generally tap roots. Roots in some genera have fungal association in the form of what? Mycorrhiza. Okay, roots in some genera, they have fungal association in the form of mycorrhiza. So this one generally we can see in Pinus. While in some others, that for example in Cycas, small specialized roots called coralloid roots are associated with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. Okay, so in Cycas, the roots called coralloid roots that are associated with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria, whereas roots in Pinus, there is a fungal association in the form of what? Mycorrhiza. So whatever the fungal species identified here are Rhizopogon, Amansia, Polytis. Okay, so these are all comes under Basidiomycetes. So once again, I'll repeat this one. So gymnosperms plants here, the root, okay, the roots are generally tap roots. One is generally, the roots are generally tap roots. The roots in some genera, they have fungal association in the form of mycorrhiza. For example, in Pinus. So in the Pinus, we can see fungal association. While in others, for example, in Cycas, small specialized roots, that is called coralloid roots. So coralloid roots means that are associated with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. Whereas in Pinus, that is what a fungal association, and here in Cycas, that is what nitrogen association with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. Okay. Cycas, that is associated with nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. Nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria. Here, symbiotic association, this one helps in the absorption of nutrients and protection from pathogens. So because of the symbiotic association, whereas in Pinus, symbiotic association with fungus, and whereas in Cycas, symbiotic association with the nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria, it helps in the absorption of nutrients and protection from pathogens. Next, about their leaf. Okay, the leaves in gymnosperms are well adapted to withstand extreme of temperature, humidity and wind. Okay, so that possess all xerophytic characters, so that can withstand extreme of temperature, humidity and wind. In coniferous, the needle-like leaves, so needle-like leaves means that reduce the surface area. Their thick cuticle and sunken stomata that also help to reduce water loss. So in coniferous, they will not get sufficient water. Okay, to withstand that temperature, they having the needle-like leaves, so that reduce the surface area, and the presence of thick cuticle and sunken stomata that help to reduce what? Water loss, so that they can withstand in extreme of temperature. So once again, I'll repeat here. The leaves may be, so in that gymnosperms, the leaves may be simple. Okay, the leaves may be simple, and in some gymnosperms, we can see compound leaves. Okay, we can see compound leaves. The leaves in gymnosperms are well adapted to withstand extreme of temperature, humidity and wind. In coniferous, the needle-like leaves that reduce the surface area. So their thick cuticle and sunken stomata that helps to reduce water loss. Okay, that helps to reduce water loss. Okay, next about their plant body. So adult plants are tall trees up to 200 feet in height. They are perennial, xerophytic plants. Xerophytic plants means they can withstand extreme of temperature, humidity and wind. Then branches are dimorphic. Bimorphic means here in that plant body, we can see long shoots and dwarf shoots. Okay. Leaves are dimorphic. Dimorphic means scale leaves and green acular leaves. Means here we can see what? Needle-like leaves. Male and female cones are present on the same plant. Okay. In some, we can see male cone that is present in a male plant and female cone that is present in a female plant. So sporophytic plant body, adult plants are tall trees up to 200 feet in height. They are perennial, xerophytic plants. Then branches, here long shoots and dwarf shoots. We can see two types of branches. Then leaves also, scale leaves and green acular leaves. Then male and female cones that are present on the same plant in some species, or that is present in a different plants in some species. Let us study about the characteristics of gymnosperms. Gymnosperms that are heterosporous. Heterosporous means they are responsible for producing two kinds of spores. Okay, two kinds of spores, that is microspore and megaspore. Microspore and megaspores, which are produced in microsporangia and megasporangia. So these microsporangia and megasporangia that are born on the sporophylls. So sporophylls again here, microsporophyll and megasporophyll. And these sporophylls arranged to form male and female cones. Understood this one? The gymnosperms produce microspore and megaspore, which are produced in microsporangia and megasporangia, born on sporophylls. That sporophyll is nothing but microsporophyll and megasporophyll. Okay, and these microsporophyll and megasporophyll, that is to form male and female cones. Understood that for male and female cones, the pollen grain germinate and pollen tube reaches the male gamete into the ovule, where it fuses with the egg cell in archegonia. Okay, following fertilization, so fertilization takes place here, the zygote develops into embryo and ovules into seed. Okay, the zygote develops into embryo and the ovules into seeds. See here, by seeing this one, see here cones, these are reproductive structure, both male and female cones are made by single plant here. Cones are covered by scales. Here you can see male and female cones, and this is what cycas plant, and cycas plant here you can see that what cone. Okay, here this is what male cone, and here this is cone, pinus cones. Okay, these are pinus cones. See the structure. These are different kinds of cones that are present in different gymnosperms plants. And this is a structure of male cone. Okay, this is a structure of male cone. Here, see the structure correctly. See here, this is a male cone. Male cone that is made up of microsporophyll, and microsporophyll which is made up of microsporangium, and microsporangia that contains microspores. See this one, this is a male cone. Okay, male cone which is made up of microsporophylls, microsporophyll that containing microsporangium, and in the microsporangium we can see the microspores. Okay, see this one, male cone. Next one, megasporangium. Okay, so megaspore develops in the nucleus by meiotic division and goes on to form female gametophyte tissue. 2-3 archegonia are formed in this haploid tissue, which is food ladder. Egg cell in the venter of archegonia undergoes fertilization by the motile spermatocyte forming diploid zygote. So I will explain this one by showing the diagram here. So this is what a female cone. Okay, this is female cone which is made up of megasporophylls. So in that megasporophyll that contain mega spores. Okay, that megaspore, and that is nothing but ovule. Okay, egg. Here you can see the structure, megaspore. This is a female cone. Female cone which is made up of megasporophylls that contains what here? Megaspore. That nothing but here ovule is present. So see that this is what a sporophyte plant. So this sporophyte plant that produces two kinds of cones. Here see the structure. One is male cone and another one what a female cone. Understood? That produces two types of cones. One is male cone and another one female cone. So male cone having gametophyte, that is what a pollen grain. So this pollen grain come in contact with this one female cone having that what ovule. So when this male gamete come in contact with the ovule, the fertilization takes place and next embryo the developing seed, zygote, that develops into, okay, fertilization takes place, zygote later that develops into as a seed. So in the next diagram, see here nearly. So mature sporophyte plant, you can see mature sporophyte plant, and here that produces two kinds of spore, this one cones. First you see the mature sporophyte plant, and here you can see two kinds of see the diagram. Here we can see mature sporophyte. So this plant that produces two kinds of spores. One is male cone. So male cone means it is made up of microsporangia, and female cone, okay, this is what made up of megasporangia. So microsporangia or microsporophylls, that is made up of microsporophylls, and here that is what megasporophylls. So microsporophylls that contain microsporangia and microspore. Microspore is nothing but pollen grains. Here you can see the structure of pollen grains, that is a male gametophyte, and here you can see what female megasporangia that produced megaspores, or nothing but that is what female egg, that is female gametophyte. When pollen grains that is come in contact with this one ovule, the fertilization takes place and it forms the embryo, okay, embryo, and here development of seed takes place, and when this undergo germination, that develop new sporophyte plant. So once again I'll explain this one. See here, mature sporophyte plant. So this plant that produces two kinds of cones, one is male cone and another one female cone. Male cone, that is made up of microsporophylls, that bear microsporangia, and here female cone, that is megasporophylls, bear megasporangia. Microsporangia that contain microspores, okay. So microspore is nothing but, that is what in that forms pollen grain, which is nothing but male gametophyte. When it is come in contact with the female gametophyte, which is produced in megasporangium, nothing but egg, okay, and fertilization takes place and a formation of embryo takes place. Later the seed development takes place, and this seed when undergo germination, that develops sporophyte, okay, sporophyte plant. So in this image diagram also you can see that they here you can see that two kinds of cones here. One is what female cone, which is bigger in size, dark color, and here small yellow color one, that is what male cone, that microsporangium and microsporophyll. See the this one diagram clearly here, and this is what megasporangium, megasporophylls, and these megaspores, okay, that is what containing female gametophyte, that is what egg, and here that come in contact with here pollen grains. When come in contact with this egg, fertilization takes place, and that responsible for the formation of embryo, and seed formation takes place, and next again when the seed germinate, that give rise to new sporophytic plant. Okay, what are the importance of gymnosperms? So gymnosperms plants, they are very beautiful, okay, they having very beautiful cones. So ornamental plants are here that grown for decorative purposes. So they are ornamental plants, they are grown for decorative purposes. So in this one you can see jinkago and other pines, cycads and neatum species that are used in decoration of lawn and park etc., because they having very beautiful structures here. various species of gymnosperms that can also be grown as a bonsai. Bonsai means that is dwarf plants, okay. So ornamental plants grown for decorative purposes, jinkago and other pines, neatum species that is used in decorative of lawn, parks, etc. Then various species of gymnosperms can also be grown as bonsai. That is nothing but dwarf plants. And here species of cycas, here you can see that images, species of cycas are used for decoration purposes. Then jinkango, beautiful ornamental leaves, okay. Biloba, that possesses beautiful ornamental leaves. Okay, thank you.